Karnataka, the big news that's coming in is about the Revanna family. Senior Revanna has been sent to the SID custody. However, he has mentioned that this is a political vendetta against him. However, the special investigation team, and this is a big news, if you have any information, if you have any evidence with you on this case, must reach out to the special investigation team. They are urging victims, informants to contact the police over this. They have also assured and maintained that there will be a confidentiality over this case. The SIT has put forth a statement saying they request victims, anyone who has any information, to reach out to the officers, and that confidentiality, that means their identities will not be revealed. They can secretly send out that information. They are also warning, and this is for any user, if you have received a video allegedly belonging or that has Revanna and the sexual abuse allegation issue in it, do not circulate, do not spread it, the images or the photographs, because there could be legal action taken against those who are sharing and circulating. Remember, you're talking about women from underprivileged groups, domestic help, any woman who has been employed and possibly has got caught in this net. It's their identities, their respect and life also at stake. Do not circulate where the identities are being revealed. And remember, amid all of this, there has to be a certain sensitivity and responsibility that must be maintained, and refrain from revealing the identities of the survivors and the victims. So that's the big news coming in. The SIT has been on this case right now. This SIT, remember, is via the Karnataka government that has made the announcement. And we are told that the SIT has reached out. There are about two victims for now, if I'm correct, who have come out. More victims possibly, or more women may want to come forth and speak up, but their fear, and what happens as a conclusion, the threats against them, all of this is understandable. Therefore, the SIT has said, one, that the confidentiality, the secrecy of the identity of those victims and whistleblowers will be maintained. If they have information, reach out. And also, do not circulate videos where the identities of these women and survivors can be revealed. Anaga Keshav joins me for the latest on that. Anaga, on one hand, there is clearly a sensitive issue. Many women who possibly have been recorded cannot imagine what they must be facing right now. But on the other hand, there has to be evidence. Because if an individual has to be caught, there has to be solid evidence, solid information that can be bagged as a legal case. At this point, how has the SIT team ensured that more and more people can come forth on this?
Well, Pooja, the SIT has opened up a helpline under the promise that the identities of the victims will remain anonymous. None of the name, details, address, or even the incident that unfolded will be revealed. However, if a victim calls to that particular number and files and narrates the incident, a complaint will be registered, but the identity will not be divulged, is the promise that the SIT team has given. Apart from that, even the state government has promised financial assistance for the victims to ensure that they are protected. They are not threatened by use of money or power or muscle power. They have been given all sorts of assurances by the state government to ensure that the maximum number of victims come forward and file their complaint. Because remember, Pooja, the more the victims, the stronger that this case gets. And once Prajwal Revanna and HT Revanna get convicted, they will have to serve imprisonment. So the SIT team is doing all that they can to ensure that more and more witnesses, more and more victims come forward and file their complaint. Of course, the team will be probing the complaints registered. And yeah, once it gets proven, then the law will take its own course of action.
And the fear among possibly many of these women and survivors is understandable. Remember, you're talking about the most influential family, political family of Karnataka. Former Prime Minister Deve, Gowda's son and grandson, who are facing these charges. They've denied it, but it's the women who have been employed know fairly well how influential they are and possibly are being threatened. That is why they have to be encouraged to come out and speak, and that they will be protected. That's what the law also must provide at this point. Appreciate you joining us, Anaga, for the latest on that. What is the latest update on this? One of the most disturbing developments surfacing from the southern state and in this election season. Now, HD Revanna, who's the son of Deve Gowda, who's the father of Prajwal Revanna, has been sent to SIT custody. It's also become a huge political showdown, expectedly. The court on Sunday extended Revanna's custody. He will now be in custody till the 8th of May. Intensifying the probe, SIT has launched a helpline number for victims and informants who can reach out, and their identity will be protected. But HD Revanna hitting back has called the SIT custody a political conspiracy. Revanna Sr. is alleging that there is no evidence against him. His political life is a clean slate and he is just being deliberately targeted by the political, and that is the ruling party in the state. HD Revanna is also facing a kidnapping case following allegations that his associate abducted Revanna's house help, harassed her on Revanna's instructions. Meanwhile, where is this man on your screens? The young man Prajwal Revanna, who is in the center of this harassment allegations. We are told he clearly appears to be still in Germany. Is he on a vacation despite all of these charges against him? SIT has issued a lookout notice against him. And because this brings in the name of the Deve Gowda family, Deve Gowda has been former Prime Minister of this country, apart from, of course, holding senior government positions. And because the family's name is being brought in, according to our sources, Deve Gowda is extremely pained by the recent developments about HD Revanna and Prajwal Revanna, his son and grandson. We are told that the family is even advising him not to constantly track the news, that he's been tried to be kept away from the latest updates that are coming in. Deve Gowda has told the associates to let him be alone, not give appointments to anyone. So Deve Gowda is not holding any public meetings right now because of all that is happening. Nagarjun Dwarkanath joining us for the latest. He gets us this information from the Deve Gowda family. HD Deve Gowda is about 90 years of age, if I'm correct, Naga. And that at this point, clearly because his name is being dragged, everyone is referring to this case as the Deve Gowda family, the influential political family. What are you picking up about what the mood is inside the family at this point?
In fact, Pooja, good morning. Deve Gowda is 91 years old. He just turned 91 okay. this year. And because one thing that is influential family and also the former Prime Minister of India.
Yes.
And what happened was his son was arrested from his residence. So it's a big embarrassment for the family where Revanna was arrested from the former Prime Minister's residence itself. Revanna was picked up from the SIT from Deve Gowda's house. That caused a huge shock to Deve Gowda, is what family members are saying. The family members have advised him not to watch any news channels and read newspaper. And Deve Gowda himself has told his associates not to give any appointments, fresh appointments for people to meet him, is what he's being advised. And family has told him that he's in extreme state of shock and pain because Prajwal Revanna's case has become news across the country, and now Revanna has been arrested in a kidnap case. So looks quite bad on the family. And the moment people are talking about, they're talking that it's Deve Gowda and family. They're not specifically speaking of Prajwal Revanna and Revanna himself. And the former Prime Minister's name is being dragged. Kumar Swamy, time and again, I've said that please don't drag Deve Gowda's name into this. He's earned his name for the last 6 years.
All right, so that is one of the reasons that Deve Gowda hasn't given out an official statement on this, and because it's his name. But remember, the allegations are too serious to be ignored. It concerns many women, of which numbers are still emerging, that who were regularly abused, harassed, even sexually assaulted by allegedly HD Revanna and the son Prajwal Revanna, even though both of them have denied the allegations and said these are WARF videos, while sources say there are about 3,000 videos in the pen drives that belong to Prajwal. It's an investigation. These are developing details. We'll continue to track the latest on this.